Did you know that you can style your console log messages in DevTools with CSS? It's quite simple, really, and it will help you make your console log a little bit more organized and your console log messages a little bit more distinguishable. I'll show you exactly how it works and a practical example of where and how it can be really helpful and really useful for you. Alright, I have a landing page for my course Mastering LinkedIn open here, and if I want to immediately jump into console of my DevTools, I can hit Command Option J shortcut, and this will immediately open console as developer tools are opened. On Windows, this should be Shift Control J. I'm going to zoom in here with Command Plus so you can see a bit better what we're talking about. Let's just log something to the console, console.log, and let's just say CSS weekly. This is plain old, simple, and very good console log that you've been using all day, every day. But you also probably know that there are handy methods that are styled a little bit differently, console warn and console error. So let's try them out. Instead of console log here, we're going to have console warn, and this will give us a nice little warning. We can also run console error, in which case we will have a nice red message. There's an error in our console. So those are the most straightforward ways to style your console log messages. Let's clear this console, and I can easily clear it if I just run clear or console.clear. But the easier way would be to hit keyboard shortcut Control L. This is working on Windows and on Mac. And on Mac, you also have Command K if you want to clear the console. If you want to see all functions that are available within console object in DevTools, you can just hit console and hit enter. And if you expand this, you're going to see all functions that are available. Some of those we've already covered and some of those we will look into. In any case, this is exactly how an object representation looks in console. The same thing would happen if I tried to log this into a console log. Let's try it. Console.log. And in parentheses, I will have console. Console is a global object. And this is exactly what we get, result that we see here. You can expand this and you can dig into this object in details. But there is also a very visual way to display an object in console. And this would be using console table. Console.table, and let's just log console again. And here you're gonna see that there's a nice table with keys and associated values. We don't get really much here, but sometimes it can be very handy to display an object using the console table to get a glance at all the values that are associated with that particular object. And while I'm talking about objects, let me show you another thing really quickly. If I have a constant here, let's say const CSS weekly equals CSS weekly, it is going to be a string. And when I wanted to output this variable, I would do something like this, console.log. And then I would say CSS weekly in quotes, comma, and then the actual variable CSS weekly. This would then allow me to immediately see what value is associated with that particular variable. But there is a much handier way to do that. You can just run console.log, and you can create an object here. And that object is going to be CSS weekly R variable. And this will then give you this nice little representation where you can immediately see the variable and the value associated with that particular variable. Another thing that you might be aware of is console.group. And console.group is a way to group certain console log messages into one group that is hidden behind a certain dropdown. Let's see how it looks. Console.group. And here, in parentheses, you have a label for that particular group. Let's just say my test group. I will just add a couple of more commands here. Of course, you would probably use console log from your editor. I'm just using Chrome Developer Tools just to quickly show you how it works, but you're probably using Visual Studio Code. And if you are using Visual Studio Code, I have a number of videos here on Visual Studio Code, so check those out. Link to one of those should be on the screen right now. In any case, console.group, and I'll just do a couple of console logs here. Console.log, I'll just say one, and let me copy this. I'll just say two, and I'll just say three. And to close that particular group, you would run console.group end. And in parentheses should again be a label that you specified when you opened or created the group. There we go. And now this is how this group looks like. So if you have a number of console logs throughout your code, you can group some of those that are related into a group, and then you can hide them or show them when you want so they're not cluttering your entire console. And if you noticed, when I ran this console.group command, console.group was expanded, like you see right here, but there's also another command, console.group collapsed, and this would, by default, make this group collapsed. So you will have to open it if you want to see the values inside. If you're running console.group, this group is automatically going to be expanded, and if you're running group collapsed, then the group will be collapsed by default. Something to keep in mind. In any case, what I really wanted to show you in this video is the way to style console log messages. To style console log messages, all you need to do is you need to use format specifier. And format specifier is basically this, percentage %C. This will allow you to add CSS to your console log message. So let's try it out. Console.log. In string, I will have this string specifier, percentage %C, and then the string that I want to style, which will be CSS weekly in my example. And now the second parameter in my function is going to be the style that I want to apply to this particular string designated with this format specifier. So let's try it out. This is again going to be a string. Color is going to be yellow and font size is going to be 2 rem units. And you see immediately that this looks quite a bit different. Of course, you don't have to manually specify styles every time. You can create a variable with some kind of a style and then you can pass this into your console log whenever you want to style messages. So let's do that. I will copy this code and I will create a variable. Let style is going to be exactly this string. And now we can run it again, but we don't have to specify the string directly. We can just use the variable that we've created. Now, for obvious reasons, the CSS that is available for styling console log messages is quite a bit limited. So you won't be able to do something like display none or change positioning. This is not going to work. You see that it's still displayed because the console will not allow you to mess up layout of developer tools by tweaking CSS of a certain message too much. And just as well, if I try to change positioning, position absolute, for example, and let's clear the console so you can see it a bit better. And this is another handy thing to know. If you're writing something and you clear the console, you will not lose your input. So you can clear the console whenever you want and you won't have any problems with losing something that you typed in. And if we tweak here, inset inline start, let's set it to something like 5 rem units. You will see that this makes no difference to our console log. And if you're wondering, inset inline start is a logical CSS property that is equivalent to left property. If you want to learn more about logical CSS properties, check out my video on logical CSS properties. The link should be on the screen right now. Now, this example that I'm showing you here on styling might not be particularly ideal, but there's a better way to actually make this styling useful. For example, you can add labels to your console log messages, in which case it might be a little bit easier to keep track of the things that you're doing, that you're logging in your console. So what I want to do is I want to create a label, and let's just say the label is going to be debug. So I will create another style here, style debug, and we will add a little bit of styling. Color is going to be black. We're going to have background color set to yellow. We're going to have border radius set to 5 pixels, and we will have padding set to 0.5 rem units. Let's try it out. We're going to use style debug here. Now this is how the label should look, and I think it's a little bit too much, so let's reduce the padding to something like 0.2 rem units. Let's try it again. Console.log. All right. But what we want here is, let me clear the console, we want to have a debug message, maybe something like this. And then after this label, we want to have the value that we will be logging, and this will be CSS weekly in our example. If I just ran this command right now, you're going to see that everything is within the style that we've created. But format specifier allows you to specify number of different replacements. So we can add another format specifier, and I will add it immediately after my debug keyword, percentage %C. And now rest of the string or CSS weekly will be formatted with a different set of rules. And this will then be specified in another argument. Another argument, let's just set it, for example, right now to an empty string. This will effectively clear all the styles that are created. So we're adding styles here in style debug to this particular part of string. And then we have another part of the string that we also want to style. This will be CSS weekly or this part, and we will style this with, well, basically with no styles, default console styling. So let's run this, and you're going to see that this is how it works. I probably need a little bit more spacing here, so let's add space here, not like this, but rather like this. There we go, and we can also tweak styling just a little bit. We probably need padding inline to be a little bit bigger than padding block. So padding block is going to be 0.2 rem units and padding inline should be something like 0.5 rem units. There we go. And now if we run our console log again, you're going to see that we have this nice label that will help us distinguish our console log messages. Now, if you have a number of those console log messages, It can be really handy to style them this way so you can immediately see what you need to focus your attention on. And of course, you can use any number of format specifiers, and every format specifier will format the string after it until the next format specifier. So hopefully this gives you an idea about how to style your command log messages and how to use different console commands to get a little bit more out of your console log experience. And as we're looking at the landing page of my course here, Mastering LinkedIn, which is actually a course on mastering Prettier and Styling, where I go into details about those tools and how to get the most of those, then I want to give you a discount. So use the coupon code CONSOLELOG to get additional 40% discount on already discounted pre-launch prices. Thank you so much for your attention. My name is Zoran Nambor. I will see and hear you in a different console log message. Styled, of course. Or rather, in the next video.